Welcome to the CAD Office Training Guide Series for FDOT Connect. I am Nathan Myers, Assistant BIM Technician and Structural Engineer at WSP USA. Today I'll be going through the OpenBridge Modeler Training, Volume 1, Introduction to Model-Centric Design. In this series of videos, we will take you step by step through each exercise from the guide. In this session, we will continue to go through Chapter 5, looking specifically at the creation of beam layouts and beams in OpenBridge Modeler. So following exercise 5.1, where we created the deck and the barriers, we're going to be creating the beams and beam layout here in exercise 5.2. This follows the top-down approach used in OBM modeling, where we create the deck according to the vertical alignment, which is not shown here, but we'll follow the top of the deck, and the deck is created down from there. And then the beams are placed underneath of it. The beams are placed according to a beam layout, which is actually created first on the 2D plane. And then the three-dimensional beams are placed to follow this beam layout. So let's get into the exercise. So I've gone ahead and opened the exercise 5.2 begin file, which shows where we left off in exercise 5.1. So now we can begin creating our beam layout before we create our beams. So if we go up to Home, Superstructure, Beam Layout, and we pan into the view window, we will be prompted to select our start limit line. So we want to select the full extent of our beam. So we want to select support line 1 and support line 4 as our end limit line. We can left click or data point to accept. And this opens up our beam layout definition window. So this window has a lot going on in it. You can see at the top there's some basic information about beam layout. We have our list of spans on the left-hand side, and then we also have the details for the selected span in this main window. So our alignment was selected based on the active bridge model, which is the one that we are currently in. You can also select auxiliary alignments if you have some more complicated structures. You can also select a placement method between continuous and simple. So if you have a simple span, you have three spans going between each of the support lines, or if you want a continuous span, the beams will go all the way from support line 1 to support line 4. But for this bridge, we want a simple span, so we will select simple. Now, the creation of this beam layout can be streamlined in some ways if you have spans that are identical. So this use default feature, it can be pretty useful. So if I were to select use default, this span and the details of it will be determined by whatever the default span has been set as. So the first span, support line 1 and support line 2, has been set as the default span. So if I make changes to this span, it will also change this span. Now, this box has not been checked off, so the third span will not be changed along with those other two. So if I were to increase, I have the first span selected and it shows the beams that are currently in there. So I'm going to increase this to 4 just for an example. So now if we go down to span 2, you can see these beams have changed accordingly and you're not able to edit them because you can only edit the default span. Now going to span 3, these beams have not changed from what they were prior because the use default box was not checked. Now if you have spans that are very similar but are not quite identical, you should not use this tool because whenever you uncheck this box, so if you were to make the changes to the default span that are the same between two spans, if you were to uncheck the span to make the final tweaks to the this checked span, all the changes go away. So you can only use the default that the spans are exactly identical. So let's begin modifying our spans to match our model. So let's come up to our number of beams, increase this to 7. We want our edge distance, because we have some errors here. The OBM does not like it when the beams are placed directly on the edge of the deck, as they are here. So we're going to set an edge distance of 2 foot, 6.5 inches. We'll hit tab, and we check to make sure our equal edge distance box is checked, because if we do not, it will only change the left beam, but not the right beam. So let's hit apply, and we see it changes our left and right beam to 2 foot, 6.5, and it also changes the other beam spacing accordingly. So next we're going to uncheck this beam start, same beam start end values box. And we're going to go into changing the support line offset. So this support line offset will move the start and end values of the beam from the support line. So for this span, we're going from support line 1 to support line 2. If we change the start support line offset value for the beam start to 3 inches, like we will be in this exercise, this will move each of these beams forward 3 inches. So there will be a space of 3 inches between the support line and the beam start. We want to do the same, changing this to -1.5 inches for the beam end. So now the end of the beam will stop 1.5 inches short of support line 2. So now let's go ahead and do the same thing for the second and third spans. We want to change this to 7. Apply that edge distance. And now this value will be a little bit different. We're going to change this to 2.25 inches. And hit tab to input that. And -2.25 inches. And you can just click in another box to get that input. And the last span. And the offset should be 1.5 inches and -3 inches. So now it looks like we have all of our beams incorrectly, at least the beam layout. So if we want to check to make sure that these are correct before actually placing the beam layout, we can hit this validate box, which will show the spacing and give a preview of our beam layout in the model. Let's go ahead and click validate. So now after clicking validate, we can see the preview of the beam layout in our two-dimensional window. So this shows our spacing. It also shows the start and end of our beams. And everything looks to be correct. So we can go ahead and click save to actually place the beam layout. So here we have our beams, our beam line work or layout input into the model. So we can see it shown both in the left view window and in the right view window. So before we place our beams on our beam layout, let's go ahead and verify that our beam layout has been placed correctly compared to the extents of the deck. So let's first hide the barrier so we can see the full extents of the deck. If we come up to the home tab into the level display, we can hide our traffic railing. Just like that. Now we're going to measure the distance between the leftmost beam and the deck edge by going to analysis and reporting, over to measure, and then measure distance. So let's zoom in on our left deck edge. So this distance between this beam and the deck edge should be 2 foot 6.5 inches. And we can measure that by first snapping onto our deck edge. And then we can add a perpendicular snap by coming to our snaps and going to perp. So now it should snap perpendicular. If I left click on that beam, it shows when it's flattened to the Z file, that is 2 foot 6.5 inches, which is exactly what we want. So let's do the same thing at the start of our beam. If you remember, we set this offset to 3 inches. So the distance between this beam start and the beginning of the deck should be 3 inches. So we're going to do the same process, select the deck, go to our perpendicular snap, then click on our beam start. And as you can see, the flattened to file Z measurement is 3 inches, which is exactly what we want. So now we can begin placing our beams on our beam layout. So let's go up to our home tab and go over to our place beam. Now we're prompted to do a few things. So before we select the beam layout, let's just make sure that our feature definition is correct. So this feature definition will change the feature definition window that will pop up after we select our beam layout. So you can select between both concrete beams and steel beams. I'm going to see here concrete or steel. We want to stick with concrete for this bridge. Make sure that's selected. And now we can go and left click on our beam layout to select it. And let's accept by left clicking. So similar to the beam layout window, our spans are shown on the left-hand side. Now they are populated with the beams that we put in the layout. And in the main section here are the details where we actually define the characteristics of each individual beam. There are a few ways that you can navigate this. And similar to the beam layout, you can duplicate different beams. So you have a few options. So you could select apply to all beams, which will mean that any changes that you make to this window will apply to every single beam on the list. Or if you wanted to, you could uncheck that apply to all beams and you can copy two. So let's say, so all these beams right now have a zero haunch. Just for an example, so if I want to change this haunch to 1 inch, select away. So now if I only wanted, say, the span to beam L to have that same characteristic, I right click on the span one beam L, click on copy two, and now I select all the other beams that I want to have the same characteristics as this span one beam L. So if I go to span two beam L and I hit copy by ratio, this span two beam L will also share that 1 inch haunch, which for any changes that you make to that span one beam L, but that haunch was just used as an example. So all the other spans are, excuse me, all the other beams were not changed, but that beam L. Now for this bridge, all the beams are going to be exactly the same. So let's hit apply to all beams. So if you're following through the manual, we are in step 15. So we're changing this beam type to custom. We're going to change the haunch start and end to 1.5 inches and 1.25 inches. We're going to change our start template to the standard section, FDOT, HASHTO, type 2. So let's just verify that all of these inputs are correct. And we can hit OK to place the beams in our model. So now we have the beams placed into our model. You can see them both in the plan view and in our perspective view. So all these beams share the exact same characteristics, exact same haunch, cross-section, etc. So for this bridge, the haunch is actually going to be different due to the varying camber and super elevation. So we need to go in to the feature definition again and modify the haunch for each individual beam. So to get back into that window, we can hover over our beams, click on the Properties tab, go down to Beam Definition, and hit the ellipsis. Which opens back up our beam definition window. So now the next step is to modify the haunch for each individual beam just to properly match the actual bridge that we're creating. Those haunch values have been calculated by hand in a separate program, so we will not be calculating those. But you can just follow it. If you're following the manual, there is a table that shows the correct haunch for each individual beam. But I will just skip to the end file just so you can see what those inputs should look like. So now I've opened up the 5.2 end file. You can see as I scroll through the beams that the haunch start and haunch end values have been modified per this bridge. So if you change all of those to match, you can hit OK, and it will place the beams in correctly. So that is the end of this exercise. You should be seeing the view as I have here. Thank you for joining me today for the CAD Office Series F. This was exercise 5.2 for the OBM Intro to Model-Centric Design Guide. In the next video, we will complete exercise 5.3 to add substructure elements to our bridge model.